Hello everybody, it's Eva from Bohemian Crafting here again, and today I'm coming to share with you these two journals. This is already sold, this will be listed on my Etsy. And after showing you quickly those two journals, I would like to show you how you can create these covers. It's easy, it's not too hard, you just need to have some embossing machine and embossing folders, and it's really great decoration for your journals, for your books, for maybe photo albums, for planners. And you can do it a little bit different way than I did it here, but I'm gonna show you that basic. So these are my journals. This is about birds, and I used a lot of envelopes, and I like that blue of envelopes. I tea-dyed them, and it's full of ephemeras, full of book pages about birds, and full of tags, pockets, as I normally do. And I'm just gonna show you what is in this journal, and I'm gonna talk something about our craft family. I had a chance to meet one of us, one of our craft family, while ago. Michelle from here, from England, she purchased one of my lab books, and she didn't want me to send her that lab book. She wanted to pick it up in person. And we met, it's a few weeks ago, we met, she came to visit me with her amazing family, and I'm so happy. It's always, I felt so scary. I was not scary, I was scared how it will go, because, you know, it's, if you don't know what you can expect, so it's scary. But I have to tell that she has amazing family. She is so wonderful person, very polite and nice, and we have amazing afternoon. And she came with her husband and with her son. Her son, his name is Owen, and he is wonderful guy, wonderful young guy. I called him young Harry Potter. That my house was visiting young Harry Potter, because he's so clever, and he learn those magics, those card magics, card tricks, and he's really wonderful in that. We had amazing afternoon. He showed me so many tricks, and I still don't realize how he did these all these tricks. Oh, yep. While I'm talking, I'm gonna show you what is in this journal. So it was a really amazing afternoon, and I'm so happy I met them. Hi, Michelle. Hi, family. I'm so happy I have a chance to meet you. It was amazing, and oh, you are so amazing people. So if you have a chance to meet someone from our craft family, I think you should try it, because it's always so beautiful, and it can be so surprising. I had that wonderful day with them. It was really wow. So this is my just jump into craft video. So this is a journal about birds. As you can see, I found few beautiful pictures with birds, that with Kate and those small chickens. It's amazing. And here I love this bird cage here. And I've got here in this journal few pages about birds, about interesting things about birds. It's full of pockets, full of tea-dyed papers. And as I said, I used loads of envelopes in this journal. Okay, come on. Yeah, I put that notepaper inside of those envelopes to decorate them a little bit. I really like this picture, it's so wonderful. So I had this wonderful evening with one of us. Oh, I forgot to stamp. Here is like double pocket. One it's here, small one, and other one it's behind. And I embossed these small brown pockets with my embossing folder. I decorate these flaps of envelopes. And thank you so much to all of you for your amazing comments from my previous video, when I shared that I had to learn how to deal with no nice messages. And Thank you so much. I know I've got hundreds of you who supporting me all the time. And I know I have to agree that bad messages sometimes come in, but it was, you know, it was not surprising. It's not like it was surprising. It was something what I can't change right now. Even I wish it was about my English. And you know, I apologize for my English. I do. And it was, I didn't know how to continue because my English, maybe it's getting a little bit better, but not fast. I was always very bad with languages, even with my language, my native language. I wasn't a great student. I was more in creating and more in math and chemistry than in languages. So to be honest, I am kind of proud of myself that now I can say that basic in English. If my teachers will know that I can say this, what I'm saying now in English, they will be wow. You know, so I know my English is not perfect, and you know, I apologize because I want you to know that I care. I wish to speak perfectly English. But as I am a self-student, I do many mistakes. I know it. I'm trying to learn not to do them. But sometimes, you know, I'm human only. So please bear with me. Bear with me. I will learn. I will learn as much as I can do. I will. I promise. So I know I should deal with these messages better way. But yeah, you know. More you try to ignore it, then it got you deepest, deeply. So these are pockets. I've got here a few pictures. This is by the way, it was accidentally transferred from other paper. I let them, I soaked them with tea, and then I put stack of these papers just on plate. Before I put them dry, and it was somehow transferred between two papers. So this is accidentally transferred paper. And here, look at this, how amazing. So it's this journal, this is already sold, and I have to send it. It has loads of pockets, loads of space for journaling. I left all these envelopes plain. I didn't put there any paper to cover them, because I was thinking that more space for journaling, it's better. Oh, these are really gorgeous, this one. And I used Tim Holtz cabinet dies to decorate those envelopes here. This, so this is hopefully quickly showing this journal. And I've got that smaller, a little bit smaller journal. It's made kind of same way, using envelopes and tea-dyed paper. Here is pocket and some embellishment. And the, in that second journal, I used also Wonderful Collections. I will show you. I will tell you about these collections when I will show you that journal. Here, those two tags. And here again, these are pages from book about birds. And it's a really beautiful book. So I'm using it now for crafting because I really like birds. You know, now when better weather starting, you can hear them at morning. And it's so refreshing. So refreshing to hear their voices. I like this name, Brambling. It's so good. Brambling. So I really like birds. Oh, look, this is not my picture, like my picture, but I was totally the same. I grew up on a small farm. We had all kind of pets. My daddy still has many pets, pigs and what is it? Lambs? Oh, sheeps, lamb is that meal in it. Sheeps and chickens and gooses and what, rabbits, any kind of those animals he has on his small family farm. And I've been grow up in this kind of not situation in on farm. So I've been farm girl. I woke up very early. I helped my parents to feed them, to change that what is under all those animals. They are sleeping on, what is it, hay fever. So it will be probably hay under all those animals, that dry grass, I think it's hay. So I've been changing that hay under those animals. So I'm farm girl. So that picture, it's kind of myself. That I did looks like that. And I really like all kind of animals. We always had so many animals at home. Deer. And I always gave names to all. Oh, look at this picture. I still don't understand how they did it. How they how they took this picture. If really that bird kidnapped that pure child. I don't understand how they did it. So this is last pocket. Oops. So as I said, this journal, it's already sold. But I've got that smaller one. And here is closing. I decorated with small tags. And here I made same way as I did that cover. I did this one. And I'm gonna show you very fast way this second journal. In the second journal, I used collections from oh my god, Max Garden Shop. I will put links down below. I used cafe latte. It write in French, and I'm not sure if is it say cafe latte. It's like latte, you know, cafe latte. And also Sherlock Holmes collection. These two collections has amazing ephemeras, amazing papers. I used them few times before, and with this journal I kind of went back in memories. And here I decorate this cameo with Idea Patina liquid. I used blue patina and also rust patina. So here you can see beautiful papers. They has kind of very light printing, the damask printing behind, and those coffee stains. And in this journal I've got loads of pockets and ephemeras and photographies. Oops, no, come on, go there. And covers for both those journals I made very similar way. You just need to find some good fabric and some cardstock or carton you're gonna use. Prepare your cover, and I'm gonna show you, oops, what I made after that. So it looks like this. Loads of spaces for journaling, loads of pockets and beautiful pictures about coffee time, tea time, because I use that cafe au latte collection. So I used also few pictures about coffee time and tea time. And here is pocket. And I did few small stamping in this journal. Here is pocket with small ephemera. And here it's open like this. Another ephemeras. I used few laces to decorate these tabs. Here is pocket, large pocket. And here is like double pocket. And here ladies on their tea time. Again, some ephemeras. Oh, here, look at that paper. It's a really gorgeous paper. So I will put links to Max shop down below, so you can have a look which collections I used. Here is old ephemera from my country. Oops. And here is large pocket with tag. Here is small pocket with this picture of ladies. Go there. And from that other side, we has this is small ephemera. This is from this collection as well. And here another ephemera. Come on, Evie. I'm too slow when I speak about all those ephemeras. Here's some stamping. Again, some laces. Coffee dyed paper. Craft paper. So, I really played with this journal. Here, a large pocket with these two ephemeras. And here we've got this tea time and this ephemera. And here, look these papers. They are wonderful for old vintage style journal. Really wonderful. And it's with four pockets here, with four tags, and also a pocket here. Here I used my stencil. So here is small pocket as well. Here those two girls. And here another paper from Max Garden Shop. Really gorgeous paper. Really gorgeous paper. Here another picture with ladies on the tea time. Another small ephemera. Oh, this I glued. It's open like this. It's like very small teeny tiny booklet. Tuck spot. Here this gorgeous picture. I really like all those tea times in garden. It's so refreshing. When it's nice weather, I'm having my morning coffee after work in my garden with my dog. And it's really good. Really refreshing. And it's really good. When it's sunshine, it's so, oh my God, refreshing. Yeah, I said that already. It's so nice to be sitting in garden. I have to do my garden. It looks really disaster after winter. Really disaster. So I'm deciding to move it somehow, to redecorate it, rebuild my garden, like rebuild. Look at these ephemeras, beautiful ephemeras. These are from that cafe au latte. Au latte. I'm not sure how to say that. I know it's right in English, not in English, in French, but I'm not sure how to pronounce that. But there is so many beautiful ephemeras like this. Gorgeous ephemeras. In both collections. In that Sherlock by Watson I used here, or in that Cafe Latte collection as well. Really gorgeous collections. If you wanna do vintage journal, you can't go wrong with those two collections. So, here, I'm not sure if my camera will take it, but you can see very light cocoa pyrrhot in that back. And over with small stripes. It's really gorgeous, very gorgeous paper. And I even didn't have to distress all these edges you already printed out like this. I used the distress ink around to match my background paper, if I can say so. But it has all these marks all around, so you will don't have very hard job with this. They are really beautiful papers. And here, last pocket with last ephemeras. And again, closing with this. Beautiful clips. And this small tag. Oh, I'm sorry. And now I would like to show you how I made this 3D effect. It's really gorgeous and it's not too hard to make it. What you need is embossing machine. I've got my big shot a while ago. I think it's 2, 3, maybe 4 months ago. I swapped my blue small big Sizzix with this large one. This is A4 size big Sizzix. And I have to say this was one of those most great shopping I ever did for crafting, because this machine, it's wonderful. It's so useful and I'm so glad I purchased this one. So if you wanna change your present machine for some another one, this is great to use. It's hand moving. It's not on any electricity engine, but it works really well, and I'm so happy I did it. So, what do you have to do? You have to find some cardstock or box from Cereali. Here I used, as you can see, this is base of box. I just open it, and this is base of box. From that other side, I used the denim fabric. It looks like this. I glue it down and I let it dry. It's full covered with denim fabric. It's from trousers. It's from old trousers of my son. He gave me these trousers. And now, what do you need? It's already made like book cover. It looks like this. I'm gonna use these. I'm gonna move that machine for a little bit. This was that box from, I think it was from those small biscuits. From that other side, I used fabric. Then I will cover all this inside with another layout. But for now, I need to do that 3D effect. This will be like closure. I'm gonna use some those Velcros on sides, but I'm gonna keep this, what was already here. I'm gonna keep it there, include this, and I'm gonna play with it and make it like closure. So this will be then a cover of my book. And now I would like to do that embossed embossed cover. So what I need, it's embossing machine, some embossing folders. I've got here these, and I'm gonna try to put on the top. This is from Cutterborg, and it's with these letters, and I really like this one. And on the bottom, I'm gonna try to use this, which has like waves, and this looks like feathers, or these. This is very useful folder, even if you will don't think at the first about that it's very useful, but it is. If you need to do some background, some embossed background, folders like this, they are amazing for that. So I'm gonna show you what I did. If you wanna emboss some very strong cardstock, you will need to take off all these plates. You will need to leave just this basic plate, this one. Put it in your machine. And I have to stop my video. Because my son needs something. Just a minute, please. So I'm back. So you need to take off both these plates and then try how thick cardstock you took and how thick fabric you took. First try it if it will be possible to put it through to your machine. Put your basic platform in your machine, then put one of these, and then try to put embossing folder on one side, on that first top cover of your cover, book cover. My book cover, it's here. So I'm gonna place this embossing folder on my top cover like this, and I'm gonna try to fold it as much as I can, because even if I will make small journal, it is a huge possibility that this machine, it's large, it's for A4 size paper, but still it can be hard to put it all here and fix it here in this space. But if you can, you can fold it like this and then put top plate on the top and try if it will be possible to go through. And when it's struggling, and here it's struggling because I used thick cardstock and I used thick fabric, take one layer off, that one of these plates, take it off, and I'm gonna show you, if you will notice, this is very teeny, thin layout. This is a little bit bigger, but not thick like this one. So try to change this plate for this plate. And place it like this. Your basic platform, this plate, which are using for cutting with those metal dies. And then your journal cover. And then top plate. And try to go through. And now, as you can see, it's much more easy. It's still going a little bit hard, but it's much more easy to go through. Do it like this. And yeah, here I have to stop because I'm gonna show you what I did. It's like this. And I hope you will see that. See? Hopefully. Can you? Oh, you can. Can you? Yeah, here you can see. It's on all through. If I will now take some distress ink and I will distress it, you will see that all these numbers, letters are here. They are there. They are embossed beautifully. I'm gonna show you from here. It's embossed, all that piece is embossed. It's because I a little bit swapped those plates. And this button, I'm just gonna swap my embossing folders. I will put it probably like this. And I will emboss those dots on that bottom. And I will go through to that machine. So I will have on the top of my cover, I will have these letters. And on the bottom, I will have these dots. And why it didn't went through to that machine, because I used full piece of leather include that stitching. So here it's very thick. If you have smaller machine, you can do it a little bit different way, that you will cut just piece like this, cover it with a piece of fabric, let it dry, and then go through to your machine how I showed you now, and then glue it on a top of your top of your cover for your journal, for your book. And this way I just did these two. Here I used, I'm gonna move it again. Oops, pardon me. Here I used white color. Here I used exactly same fabric. I just used white color to pop up that 3D effect. I used white acrylic paint for this one. And here I used, it was Beagle denim fabric. And then I used loads of distress inks on this one. I used Gathered Things, I used Vintage Photo, and I used, I think, I used Walnut Stain. Yes, Walnut Stain on this. And if I will show you, I'm gonna try to show you this one. I'm gonna try if it will be possible. Just go. Yeah, now you can see that a little bit better. And now I will probably use again white paint and go with that dry brush over it and make it like shabby. So this way I made these 3D effects. It's very easy. Just try to, not easy to go through to your machine with normal plates, try to change them because they've got a different thickness. You know, this, it's a little bit thinny than this clear one. So change them, swap it. You don't have to have those two clear like your layers when you are embossing or when you are cutting. There are rules, but they are not strictly rules. They are just want to show you how you can do it. But you can always can change all these plates to make it possible to use your machine for your embossing, for your cutting. So just try it. Don't go through with your material through to that machine on the edge. If how to say that right? Do not push it too hard. Do not break your machine. Just try to swap these plates. Try to layer them the way when it's not too hard to go to that embossing machine. I hope you will try it, because that 3D effect on journals, it's really brilliant. So this is my sharing for today. Thank you so very much for all your amazing comments for my previous video. I know you are right. I know I do appreciate that a lot, that you understand, that you know what I meant, that it wasn't easy to to fight with it. It really wasn't. Sometimes it's not easy to be adult. So thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for your amazing comments. Thank you so much for your support. I hope you will try this technique. And see you next time. Bye.